Well, folks, how are you all doing today? Hope you're keeping well and hope you're staying safe as well. And I'm going to share a verse from the Bible with you from the book of Isaiah today. Now, it's maybe not a very well-known verse, but it's a very precious verse and it's a very challenging verse and also it's a very encouraging verse. Isaiah chapter 50 and verse 10. The prophet asks a question. Who is among you that feareth the Lord and obeyeth the voice of his servant, and yet walketh in darkness and hath no light? Let him trust in the name of the Lord and stay upon his God. Let me quote the verse again. Isaiah chapter 50, verse 10. Who is among you that feareth the Lord and obeyeth the voice of his servant, and yet walketh in darkness and hath no light? Let him trust in the name of the Lord and stay upon his God. You know, this verse speaks about times of darkness, times whenever we can't see light at the end of the tunnel. But let's notice first of all the person the text addresses. It's speaking to those who fear the Lord, and it's speaking to those who obey the voice of his servant. This verse isn't speaking to the ungodly. It's not speaking to those who deny the existence of God. It's not speaking to those who have a form of godliness but deny the power thereof. This verse of scripture is speaking to those who love the Lord, those who have a reverential fear of God, and those who seek to obey him. They obey the words of Holy Scripture. It's speaking to those who love, fear, honor, and obey the Lord. And some of you that are listening on today, that's you. You love the Savior. You're seeking to obey the Lord. You have a fear and respect towards the things of God. But you'll notice something else, a problem that the text acknowledges. Walking in darkness and having no light. Walking in darkness and having no light. Many of God's people throughout the centuries, throughout the ages, even in this present time, are going through times of darkness. They're in the deep valley, the dark valley. And it seems that even whenever they pray, maybe even whenever they read the scriptures and they seek God, it seems that maybe there are no easy answers, no light at the end of the tunnel. Isn't it amazing that a Christian can go through times just like that? It's a problem that the text acknowledges. I wonder today, are you in darkness and you have no light? Your situation is hard. It seems that there's just a dark cloud and you can't see how you're going to get out of the situation that you're in. Who is among you that feareth the Lord and obeyeth the voice of his servant? The person the text addresses, and yet walketh in darkness and hath no light. A problem the text acknowledges. Let him trust in the name of the Lord and stay upon his God. The principle that the text advances. What's the answer? It's not some supernatural thing. It's not some sensational thing. It's simple faith. Let him trust in the name of his Lord and stay upon his God. Continue to trust. Continue to hold on to the Savior. Continue to seek to keep your eyes upon him and continue to obey him and fear him. No sensational answers, friends. Just simple trust. Stayed upon Jehovah. Hearts are fully blessed, finding as he promised, perfect peace and rest. Every joy or trial falleth from above, traced upon our dial by the Son of Love, we may trust him wholly. All for us to do, those who trust him fully, find him fully or wholly true. Continue to trust in the Lord, in your darkness, in your trial. God's in control. We think of the Savior, whenever he was on the cross, he cried out, my God, why hast thou forsaken me? And there was darkness over all the earth from the sixth hour to the ninth hour. No light at the end of the tunnel. Nothing but darkness. No sense of the favor of his Father because our sins were placed upon him. The Son of God knows what you're going through today. Who is among you that feareth the Lord and obeyeth the voice of his servant, and yet walketh in darkness and hath no light. Let him trust in the name of his Lord and stay upon his God. May God bless you all. Thank you so much for listening.